Hi, my name is Omar Yasin. I'm one of the fellows in training from Rochester, Minnesota. We are here for the 2018 ACC Legislative Conference in Washington, D.C., and we are joined by Dr. Gina Lundberg. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you, Omar.
Dr. Lundberg serves on the Council for the Georgia Chapter. She also serves on the Women in Cardiology Leadership Council. Yesterday, there was a strong attendance at the Women's in Cardiology session. Can you tell us more about that?
We had a record crowd. It was a very exciting group. We met to talk about things that are important to women in cardiology. One of our exciting sessions was on radiation exposure, particularly for our women involved in interventional cardiology, but also EP. And we also got to talk about how women in imaging, going into the cath lab, doing TEE during TAVR and other structural heart programs, are causing a lot of radiation for our women. So we talked about the exposure. Is it safe to work during pregnancy, having proper lead? That was really exciting. A session. And then we talked about microaggressions, and that's a term that not everyone knows, but what it is there are little slights that we commonly do that you might even mean in a polite or nice way. If I was to say, "What a good job you did, sweetie," that might seem endearing, but it's a little, you know, over the top, and I should respect you as a physician. So those types of gestures can be considered microaggressions. And then we had a great talk on sponsorship versus mentoring. You need someone who's really helping you get promoted, as well as sort of being your coach and keeping you positive and strong, and also possibly opening doors for you and getting you into leadership opportunities. So we had a great session.
Yeah, sounds like that was a great session. Dr. Lundberg, you were also named last year one of the top 10 women in cardiology on social media. Can you tell us more about the role of social media for fellows and for our patients as well?
Well, I am a Twitter maniac. It's a lot of fun, though. And honestly, when I started, it's really about getting news and getting it quickly. So I would get up in the morning, I might only have 5 minutes, and I could quickly go to an ACC website or JACC or Circulation, one of the major journals, and see what had just been published or what was the hot headline that day. I could also go to the news media and see what had they said on, you know, headline news that my patients are going to walk into the office and say, is aspirin good for me today or is aspirin bad for me today? You know the challenges of that. So it's a great news link. But then I started to network with fellows. I support a lot of FITs on Twitter and sort of social mentor them, if you will. A lot of connections for research and other opportunities for women in cardiology. And then it just started to expand. And as I got to legislative conference, I saw how important it was for advocacy, reaching out to your senators and your other legislators.
Well, thank you very much for being here with us today.
And thank you for having me.
For more videos like this, visit us on youtube.com/FITsOnTheGO.